On behalf of Annette Ostendorf and me, I welcome you to our presentation and say thanks for the invitation. We try to give you some insights and reflecting on the VET system, focusing on the initial vocational education and training. What are you expecting in the next few minutes? We'll start with some outline and very few data on the EVET system in Austria, and as in mostly all other European countries, lifelong learning is an issue, but the EVET, as is shown in the data throughout all countries, has importance and an immense impact on the participation of lifelong learning, therefore it's quite relevant. Then explaining some aspects of the Austrian skill ecosystem, and we will do some explanation what we mean by that, not in a very bold and broad sense, but very focused, and focus on six special pieces of a jigsaw of this ecosystem. So, what do we mean when we speak of the initial vocational education and training system in Austria? We have no system, not one system. We have two partner elements, two pillars, maybe a third one, if we take a look at the initiatives for young people seeking for training places and supported by public employment service. The diversity is eminent in our system, different VET programs and areas of specialization. The main topic today, but not only today, in political discussion is the apprenticeship system, but we have a second important pillar. In a few moments I'll refer to that. About 200 occupational or job profiles, depends on how you count in the modularization. It's not so easy to count. The duration, mostly 3 years, some 2 years, some of them 3.5 or 4 years. We have inclusive programs in framework of the VET system with partial qualifications and support for companies and young learners. And we have training courses for unsuccessful seekers for training places provided by the public employment service, but also with the same learning outcomes as the that are laid down in the occupational profiles of the company-based training. And we have the school-based vocational education training system at two levels, 650 curricula we can count, in various of areas and specializations. The duration at the intermediate level, 3 or 4 years, and the colleges for higher education, 5 years of studying. And Minister Fassmann already pointed this out, after compulsory education, we find approximately 75% of young people in Austria in VET programs, considering healthcare and nursing even more. So, both of these pillars are strong, innovative, and here's some figures, how they, the proportion between these types are found in the statistics. And it's quite interesting if you read papers of the OECD, Education at a Glance, for instance, you find in the descriptions, of course, challenges and strength of systems. And for Austria, you find written, one strength is the lot of young people in vocational education and training. And a few lines later, you read, and one of the threats is only 25 or 22% of the young people are in general academic education. There's no black and white. 34% of the young people you find in company-based training, and here in the data for the vet schools, the part-time schools, 31% in the vet colleges, and in the last 20 years, more of the leaving exams offering access to universities are made in colleges and not in general education. 12% in intermediate vet schools and the 23% in general academic education. Some aspects ongoing on the aspect of vet training, access to tertiary education. If we take a look at the formal aspect, I already told you that the vet colleges offer a free access to the universities. And since the late 1990s, also young people who took a program that was company-based have the possibility with some additional courses and exams to enter the universities and universities of applied sciences. If you take a look at the continuing vocational education and training aspects, we have the master and crafts programs, industrial master, build and craftsperson programs, focusing on professional competence development in a formal sense. We have add-on courses and post-secondary vet programs in the schools for further education. And this loops back to the access to tertiary education. We find possibilities to enter universities with vet degrees, especially in the universities of applied sciences, not a mass program. And there's the possibility for courses at the universities to access directly. At this point, I hand over for the first time to Annette.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you, Peter, for introducing our presentation and the VET system. All of you know these nice diagrams and on the educational systems and many statistical data generated to explain the current status of a system. We really need these diagrams and data to get insights to our systems. But, and that's a new point, in our view, this is not enough for policy making. There are many hidden dimensions of VET systems which are very important for policymakers and for policymaking. And therefore, we want to invite you today to look behind the curtain of the Austrian system, and we want to explain the Austrian skill ecosystem to you. No? Okay, what is a skill ecosystem? It's a term from the academic literature. In academic literature, there's a discussion on skill ecosystem focusing on substantial assets and features determining skill development in a specific region or country. The research focus is particularly on Australia, UK, and US. So it is very interesting to discuss this also for the EU. According to Feingold, a skill ecosystem can be defined as regional or sectoral social formations in which human capability is developed and deployed for productive purposes. Looking at the skill ecosystems change our view to the context of skills. What are the constraints, the conditions, and the pillars of our VET performance? Buchanan, a very famous researcher, identified some key features characterizing skill ecosystems. There are business settings to be mentioned, institutional policy frameworks, modes of engaging labor, structure of jobs, and level and type of skill formation. We try now to explain some of them for the Austrian system. And we have chosen 6 points. Six features of the Austrian systems of skills development, which are usually not obviously for readers of charts and data descriptions. They are not complete, but in our view, we can cover the most influencing ones. They are like a piece of a, or a pieces of a jigsaw within this ecosystem. So, and we've explained this 6 points a little bit more intensively. The first is the concept of Bildung, this is the most important thing I know. The concept of Beruf or profession and the idea of Bildung. The concept of Beruf or profession in German-speaking countries is still formed by a very old tradition. Mr. Fassmann mentioned this morning, and covers not only occupations or jobs. The concept of Beruf encompasses a kind of commitment to a tradition, particularly in the craft sector, individual identification with a professional field, professional awareness, a linkage to a more or less broad bundle of qualifications, and the idea that vocational education can be education, in the German sense of Bildung, in the tradition of the progressive educational movement, including general education and becoming a reflected member of society through that. That's very special for our German-speaking countries and is surely a very important pillar of the system. The concept of Beruf changed through times, but it became not obsolete. The challenge in our days is how, I hope you can read it, how to reshape the idea of vocational Bildung in workplaces transformed by digitalization and intercultural mobility without losing the asset of stability gained through this concept of Beruf and Berufsbildung. The second piece of the jigsaw is social market economy, employer engagement and responsibilities. The skill ecosystem of Austria can only be explained in the light of a social market economy. Within this model, the state frames the market activities. See later the slides on the legal framework. But the companies as suppliers of training facilities act voluntarily in every respect within a legal framework. This is the case in the dual system, but also in the full-time system, because the employers offer in the school VET model, for example, internships for students. Employer engagement in VET is quite normal in Austria, in Austrian society. That's a very big asset, I think. It can be interpreted as a part of CSR, of corporate social responsibility, and as an important feature of employer branding. Employers in Austria simultaneously benefit from offering apprenticeships and also internships for the VET school system, and they give a kind of leap of faith to the system. Employers trust in VET. That's very important, and it's a very deep-rooted trust, and it's a big asset for the system. And on the other side, the state is expected to finance an essential part of VET, especially the full-time and part-time vocational schools. So the challenge is, and this is a piece of the jigsaw, how to continuously motivate employers to engage in VET, particularly in the small and medium enterprises. Despite of the trust, they have to be motivated to produce this learning environment for the VET students. So the third one of our jigsaw, the third piece, is employment and positions based on vocational profiles and certificates. In Austria, certificates matter. Point, point, point. Yes, that's very important. They are seen as quality assurance, as a key to employability, and as a foundation of a successful participation within the social system. But the belief in certificates is also linked to aspiring to higher education following a meritocratic logic. The challenge here is, how can we increase attractiveness of VET and stop depreciation of the dual system and informal learning because of this meritocratic logic? So, we are changing now.
Next piece of the jigsaw, corporatism and democratization in the apprenticeship system. One of the preconditions why it works is because in Austria there's a well-established tradition of social dialogue. And at least one of the preconditions of the precondition is the mandatory membership in several in the chambers, not only on the employer's side, but also on the employee's side. The governance of vocational training paths, especially in the apprenticeship training, is characterized by a systematic and comprehensive involvement of social partners at all levels, on national level, on regional level, and even on company level. This includes running the apprenticeship offices by the chambers of commerce, negotiating job profiles, how broad they are, how narrow they can be, to be clear. The mix of real job-related skills and transversal competences and so on. Guidance and counseling, occupational choice, supporting young people and their parents in choosing a vocation. Collective agreements on apprenticeship remuneration. That's a structural element of the VET system in Austria. Accreditation of training companies done by both parties of the social partners. Nomination of experts for the apprenticeship leave examinations. Participation in the governance of subsidies, quality assurance measures, innovative practices, and more and more and more. But there's a challenge too. Dialogue needs time. There's a tension. Supporting quick and relevant job profiles and cultivate dialogue. Legal framework of apprenticeship training. There's a legal framework for schooling too. You know that all, but some insights on the Austrian regulations on the apprenticeship system, which is quite interlinked with school regulations, especially the part-time schools, and also with the law for child and youth employment, because apprentices are quite young in our system. It regulates aims, goals, intentions, and new quality assurance procedures in the apprenticeship system, conditions for and the accreditation of training companies, the possible structure of training regulations, the design of the qualifications, if it's modularized or not. Apprenticeship leave examinations, not the professional standards that are laid down in the specific training regulations, but the core aspects and special areas are regulated there, inclusive training, supra company training, workshops and other. Also there's a challenge. The system and the involved partners deal and negotiate, but they could employ a view from outside for developing. That's a little bit lacking, and here's my last change to Annette.
Yeah, last but not least, the sixth piece of the skill ecosystem of Austria is called VET research. Comparing research capacity focusing on apprenticeship programs with German or Switzerland VET research, particularly on universities, is not very adequately established in Austria. The skill ecosystem is in this dimension is also fragmented in this respect. There is some capacity for the school systems, the school VET system at the universities, but almost none for the dual VET at a university level. But coming soon, we have a new endowed professorship at Innsbruck University, my home university, funded by the Austrian Federal Ministry for Digital and Economic Affairs as part of the apprenticeship support program. I am reading this and explain it later. In accordance with different paragraphs of the Vocational Training Act and another law. I mention this because involvement of essential parts of the skill ecosystems can be seen in this implementing of the endowed professorship as well. You see the representatives of chambers, unions, ministries, laws, universities all have worked together to implement this professorship, and we are very grateful for it. And in Austria it gets now established, and we hope for more, maybe. But we are very happy about this. So, Peter, and now, what is your summary and outlook, and what are the consequences for the policymakers?
Small summary and outlook. A very important issue for future development of VET in Austria, or from the Austrian point of view, is to reflect the ecosystem, skill ecosystem as a whole, not the system elements per se. This has to be done technically correct and in a good way, but you have to take a look at the interactions between the several parts. Taking into account the segmentation, I showed you the data of the VET system, which is typical for Austria, should be more in the focus looking for transitions, horizontal permeability of students between schools, companies, and also it could be supported that the different sectors work together more, even more. The skill ecosystem perspective is adequate to change the perspective on VET system on an analytical purpose, on national level, on regional level, even on sectoral level. And for policy transfer to other countries, the skill ecosystem of the country has to be carefully investigated and adjusted, not only on the measurement level. So we gave some food for thoughts. We have a long tradition of double conference in Austria, not in the scientific area, but maybe we start here a tradition. Thank you very much.